Hi everyone, and welcome back to another DBT video. In the last video, we went through how to create a source and use it to build a new model. In this video, I'd like to show you what that underlying SQL actually looks like. If you look at the model as it is currently written in DBT, you have a source here. And you know, if you wanted to debug this, you know, as it gets more complicated, that's not really super helpful. So how do you know what that's doing? Every time DBT runs, it's actually compiling the SQL and storing it separately. And you can find that information in this target folder here. It's not there when you first initialize the project, but it will show up once you start to actually run models. So let's open this up. And if we look at compiled, we can see it's broken down here. It's compiling our model scripts. So we have both these in our example, as well as the one that we care about. So let's open this up. And here you can see, let's hide this. This is the compiled version, and here is the DBT version. And you can see it's using this templating here, this Jinja template, and replacing it with the information that we had put here in our YAML file. So if you ever needed to understand what is actually happening, let's say you have a really long script here with a bunch of CTE tables and a lot of custom logic with a lot of Jinja functions, you can go into the compiled folder, find what it is, but this is something you could actually copy and paste back into Snowflake directly and run it. So this is really helpful, especially when it comes to debugging, as this gets more advanced and you have sources and references. And you know, let's say we look at here, back at this example here, I don't get too many screens open. When we look back here, what this is doing, this second DBT model is using the ref function. And what this means is similar to how a source is referring to the YAML file of a source, this is referring to another model that's called My First DBT Model, which they have named it here. Again, in the last one, we saw it was looking for sources with a certain name. When you use this ref function, it's looking for models with a certain name. And if we go back to the compiled for that one, we can see it understands where this is coming from and putting the information in there. You know, you could run this directly in Snowflake. See? Whereas if you were to run, you know, this doesn't mean anything to Snowflake. So that's a little bit about how under the hood DBT is compiling your models, and it's using the different YAML files and the different templates to put it together and hopefully make it easier for you to debug if you ever need to. Thanks for watching.